Hi, Mom.
Kate! What? Have you seen the time? Why are you phoning me in the middle of the night?
Oh, sorry, Mom. I forgot about the time zones. Did I wake you?
Well, of course you woke me up. I was sleeping deeply, too. I simply gotta get my beauty sleep. I've got an absolutely crazy day tomorrow.
I'm sorry. It's just that it's real important and urgent. I haven't got a lot of time.
Well, if it really can't wait till tomorrow, Munchkin, come on, tell your mommy what's up. No way I'm calling Dad for you, if that's what you want.
Mom, listen, please. I seem to remember you're seeing a Marovich or something like that at the moment.
No. Malkovich, Munchkin. Frank Malkovich.
Yeah, right. So, but he's an opera singer, right?
That's right. They say he had the finest voice of his time, my dear. Imagine that.
That's just great. So then he must have known a famous singer called Helena Romanski. She's Russian, too. Please, if you can ask him if...
Listen, honey, if it's stars you're after, Frank knows them all. I'll just wake him up and let him tell you himself.
You mean he's...
Oh, Kate, listen, you're still there. Frank tells me he did hang out with a Romanski once, but it was platonic. You know those singers. She's a great soprano.
Great. Does he know where she went? Does she still sing? Where does she live?
One second, Munchkin. Frank says she was very ill and she was through her circulation. She went to rest in some spa somewhere. He thinks it was called Aralbad, but it was 15 years ago and he's not sure. And well, honey, when Frank wakes up, he always takes a little bit of time to get going, you know.
Thanks a bundle, Mom. And Frank, too. You're both fantastic. Love you both. And thanks again. Catch you later. Hello?
Did I wake you up? I can't sleep at all. This whole business just keeps turning round and round in my head.
What business, Dan?
But Kate, that argument we had, have you forgotten? I really need to talk about that again.
Oh, you know, I guess we were both a little high-strung, that's all. But don't sweat it, okay?
Yeah, sure. Getting carried away never solves anything, does it? I must say I felt really dumb when I hung up.
Really?
Yeah, I left the door to my office open and I was convinced everybody around heard me.
I'm so embarrassed, Dan. Please say I'm sorry to your colleagues from me.
It doesn't matter, honey. Promise me that you will never put me in that state again. You're usually so delightful. I have the impression that this journey is putting more than distance between us.
Well, it's true, I'm living a whole load of new and amazing experiences.
Okay, I see. And still no Hans Wahlberg?
No.
Keep me posted. You know how important you are to me. Hurry home, huh?
I'll try. Big hug, Dan. Director?
Ah, it is you, Miss Walker.
Director? I think I know where Helena Romanski is.
My God, you have found Helena? That is fantastic.
From my research, Helena Romanski is living in Aralbad.
Aralbad? Helena Romanski is in Aralbad.
You know the town then? You know where it is?
Of course. It was a famous spa resort. In its heyday, Aralbad welcomed all the big wigs of the regime. To be granted a stay there was a real honor. Today, the honor has gone, along with all the generals and colonels, all washed away with the sea.
It sounds like a good place if you need to take it easy or convalesce.
I think Madame Romanski would be happier here. I think she'll prefer the peace and quiet here. The perfect tranquility of our little town.
How can I get to Aralbad?
There is one way that you can. Here, in the city, there are no suitable vehicles left. But that drunk old fool living up there, he'll have something.
What drunken old fool? You mean you're not alone? What's up there?
You mean you haven't noticed the space compound on the plateau? There's still some pathetic old soldier guarding it. But he's more interested these days in reaching for another bottle than reaching for the stars.
And you think this gentleman could have a vehicle for me?
I haven't the slightest idea. If you catch him on a good day, then maybe. But good days for him are far and few between. I wish you luck.
How do I get up to the space compound, then?
There is a monorail that leads up to the Cosmodrome. When you are inside, I will activate the automatic pilot.
Why don't you come with me? After all, you're the person in the best position to convince Helena Romanski.
Unfortunately, since my accident, I seldom leave my office if I can avoid it. And it is not wise for a director to leave his city now, is it?
I remember you saying that you didn't know Hans Varlberg. It's strange because there's a photo in your museum with a man accompanied by Helena Romanski and yourself. And that man looks just like Hans Varlberg.
And so, does this prove that I know him? I think you have forgotten that only several years ago, this city was swarming with people. Do you think I actually knew every employee by their first name?
No, of course not. But the man is holding hands with Helena, so I just imagined that maybe...
Just imagined? Yes, you were. Imagining things, my dear. You have a mission in hand, Miss Walker. Pray, concentrate on it.
You know, I could get there 10 times quicker if you gave me my automaton's hands back. Then I could use my train.
Out of the question that I tamper with my pianist now. Please understand, there are still 1 or 2 finer adjustments that I must make before Helena arrives.
Okay, I'm going. Wish me luck.
I am counting on you, Miss Walker.